And joining me right now is award-winning author and playwright Pearl Clegg. Thank you so much, Pearl, for joining us here on The Southern Scene. I'm so honored to have you here on The Southern Scene with us.
Thank you.
Well, so you're here in Savannah. Now, where are you based out of?
Atlanta. I live in Atlanta.
Now, and did you grow up in Atlanta, or where did you grow up? What is your background?
I grew up in Detroit, Michigan, and all that snow and ice.
All the snow and ice. And now you're down south.
And have been here since 1969. And actually, when I got to Atlanta, I felt like I was home. I just always loved it and have never thought about moving anyplace else. I love it.
Pearl, now that you are an award-winning author and playwright, I mean, give me a little bit about your background and growing up. I mean, when did you know you were going to become this wonderful author? I mean, your books are award-winning, bestsellers list. I mean, I'm truly amazed.
Well, I am very lucky, I think. I always knew that I was a writer, even when I was a tiny little child. I knew when I was about 2 years old that I wanted to tell stories. So I used to lean over the side of my crib and tell stories to my sister, who was four. When she got to be six, she learned how to read and write, and so she taught me how to read and write when I was four, and I started writing down little stories in a notebook, and I kept them and put them aside, and I just more and more and more wanted to write stories. So I was that little kid who, after Thanksgiving dinner, you corral the cousins and you do a play. That was me.
How do you do that? Do you find your ideas? I mean, what inspires you? I mean, is it your everyday life and people you interact with?
It's exactly that. It's what I do every day. I write at home, and there's a big window right in front of my desk, so I see my neighbors walk by. I see my neighborhood grow and change in front of me, and I'm always interested in the real lives of real people, so that I'm not one for fantasy books and all of that. I just don't think that way. I'm always interested in how real people find a way to get along with each other. What happens when we don't find a way to get along with each other? Love stories, there's always a love story in my books. Whatever else the person is doing, they're always falling in love or falling out of love with somebody. But I think that the main thing I love to do is to look at people. Everybody has a story. Everybody is a walking novel, if they knew that. But they don't think of their lives that way. They're doing whatever work they've chosen. But my work, I think, is to be able to look at people and see them deeply enough to see what their story is that connects them to me, and then connect them to other people.
You know, that's music to my ears, because when we started The Southern Scene, and we often talk about that on the show, is, you know, our idea for this show was to create something to be a little different and to always be on the scene and show real people in our community. I mean, we know the political bigwigs, and it's not to take anything away from the ones who always get the media coverage, but there's some interesting people that you pass each and every day on the street, and it might be a homeless person. It might be that person that's going through domestic abuse, or who's been stricken with some terminal illness, or who's just won the lottery. I mean, but there's some really interesting people that walk our streets each and every day, and they all have a story, and that's what you write about.
That's exactly right. And I think the thing is that we sometimes underestimate our own lives, and we feel like, you know, if you're not Beyonce, you're not having a great life. If you're not President Obama, you're not having an interesting life. And what I'm always trying to convey to people is that each one of us is having an interesting life if we could look at that. But we're so out-directed so much of the time. We're looking at what other people have and what other people do, rather than seeing the fascinating stories that we are living every single day. So a lot of what I do when I write is try to create characters that people can see themselves in. So then they'll say, wow, this is an interesting person. Let me see how her journey evolves. Let me see how his journey evolves. And then they can look at those things and hopefully reflect on their own lot.
You know, Black Heritage Month, we of course look forward to this month each and every year to celebrate with so many fabulous events. What does it mean to you, this particular month, and the celebrations that we see in so many communities where we celebrate African-American heritage?
Well, I think it's really wonderful. One of the things that I really love about our country is that it's such a diverse place. There's so many different kinds of people here. And I think that if we had the chance to experience the culture of all the people that live here, if we had a chance to see the creative work that they're doing, it brings us closer together as a nation of people, because we understand that at the heart of it, we're all American people, and we have our own culture, we have our own food, we have our own traditions. But once we come together as one country, we see that all of those things, all of those cultures, have at the heart of it the same thing. We all want to live in peace. We want to raise our families. We want to grow old in peace, wave at our neighbors, drink lemonade on the front porch. And I think that part of what Black Heritage Festivals and what Black History Month, what that does, is to just remind us of how similar we all are when we can appreciate others' work.
we've all gone through personal struggles each and every day in our lives. Have you gone through personal struggles, and how have you persevered through those?
Well, I think we all do. We go through personal struggles. We have those days when we say, what am I doing? I am lost here. I don't know what I'm doing professionally and personally. But I think that's part of what makes us stronger. And I certainly have had my share of confusion, my share of messiness and all of that. But I think the thing that I learned very early, which I think is helpful, is that all you're required to do is to put one foot in front of the other. Take one step and then another and then another. And most of the time you can figure it out. I think the problem is when you throw up your hands and run in the house and say, I just can't do it. I don't know what to do. And that's not me. I am so like, okay, I'm confused. I'm going to figure this out because I have more work to do. Then I'm going to figure that out because I have more work to do.
Well, Pearl, it's just wonderful having you on the Southern Scene. I have just been so honored sitting here and talking with you. I feel like I could talk to you forever.
Thank you so much.
And I'm so excited about your book coming out. I can't wait to read it.
I think you'll love it. I think your daughter will probably like it too.
Well, thank you so much for
joining
us. And I wish you the very, very best of luck. And I hope you'll come back and see us.
I sure will.